This week in the state of New York, making the American dream a reality.
When this nation, at a time of anxiety, is struggling to find out who it is and what path to follow, New York says, follow the path forward.
Governor Cuomo was in New York City on Thursday to launch Naturalize New York, a program that makes it easier for eligible immigrant New Yorkers to become citizens. It's the first public-private partnership of its kind to lend support through the naturalization process, including a lottery for 2,000 application fee vouchers. For more information, head to naturalizeny.org. In the Bronx on Wednesday, the governor announced an additional $30 million in funding for the Urban Youth Jobs Program, which connects at-risk youth with employment opportunities across the state. The second leg of the state's first-ever breast cancer motorcycle ride kicked off last Friday to support the Get Screened, No Excuses campaign, spanning from Albany to Buffalo. The Breast Cancer Research Foundation will auction off the custom Harley-Davidson motorcycle from the ride to raise money to prevent and cure the disease. Oswego was named a first-place winner of the Downtown Revitalization Initiative and will receive $10 million to transform its downtown community. Construction has begun on the $35 million Hyatt Place Hotel in Niagara Falls, the first non-casino new development of this scale in more than 40 years in the area. The project will create dozens of new jobs and is expected to be completed in fall 2017. Lieutenant Governor Kathy Hochul presented Trooper Donald Atkinson and Trooper Lawrence Gerdo II with the New York State Police Officer of the Year Award. The pair were recognized for helping rescue a 14-year-old girl from Broome County waters last summer. We thank the state troopers and all members of law enforcement who put their lives on the line to keep New Yorkers safe each day. Until next week, that's the state of New York.